Hello, party people. Welcome to a new game of the day. This one is going to be another D4 game in our little series. This one is going to be Queen's Gambit Declined. It's going to be the Mirana variation. And we have with white Ligurich and with black Pano. This game was played in Los Angeles in 1963. And okay, let's start. We see D4 by white. D7, C4, C6. Knight to f3, knight to f6, knight to c3, e6, e3, and knight b3 d7. We see bishop d3, and black captures here, d to c4, and white recaptures with his bishop, and we see b5, which is the key move of the Mirana variation. Basically, black wants to put his bishop on b7. And the queen on b6 or c6, and pushing this pawn here down so that he will get an attack on the king side, and at the same time trying to discoordinate the white pieces. You know, if you can get b4 in and this knight has to move, basically you get messy situations, but with black you have counterplay. But we will see the drawbacks of this plan or of this variation later on. So white he plays bishop to b3, a6, the usual setup. You reinforce b5, and you want to get your bishop here to b7. And white plays e4 since he's able to grab some space in the center, so he grabs it. So basically white here has a solid center, but black is attacking on the other side. The disposition is of course equal with chances for both sides. And we see c5. A better move would have been b7. If you play this kind of opening, if you play the Mirana variation, first play b7, bishop b7, before you open up the position. Are you threatening to open up? Okay, it's not the best move for black, but black is not lost here. And white plays, or white goes for d4, d5, which is a so-called Reynolds variation. You could also play e4, e5, but again, this is it's another idea. We see c4, and you can go back, you can play bishop c2, but white here captured, and now he goes back. Black plays queen to c7, and white goes for the immediate knight to g5, and the idea is of course here to attack the e6 pawn. Black has many possibilities how to counter this. He goes for queen c6. It defends this pawn, and it prepares for b7, so that after b7 you always here eyeing down on this diagonal, and for example if white castles, then he cannot really play e5, because then you have either checkmate on g2, so it protects and it prepares to attack, which cannot be a pen move. White castles here, which is the usual plan. And now here black played the first bad move. He played e5, and he played e5 because he did not want white to play e5. The problem with e5 is that you're giving up here this square, so you have a big hole here on the square. A better move would have been to play bishop c5. And now, even if white plays e5, you capture him, and this is the idea. You want to square e4 for your knight, but even after this, this is it's a little bit better for white, but still it's okay for black. This is still playable. as I said, when your only counterplay is here on the queen side. If you get nothing going here, then you will lose. And here you got the strong bishops here eyeing down, and this is the counterplay that you need with black. The problem is now that after now that after e5, white, as I said, plays his knight to d5. Now comes bishop c5, which is the best square for the bishop, for the bishop. But the problem is that now white plays this move here. He plays his knight to e6, and you cannot take. I mean, if the queen captures, then you have here this fork here on c7. So well, what do you do? And even if you not take the other knight, the fork is still here looming in the position, so you have to move your king. And black here plays king to f7. Yeah, I mean, one of the points, if you want to evaluate the position, is always to look for the queen, for the king safety. So you compare how safe is your king and how safe is your opponent's king. And if you look at black's king and white's king, I mean, it's very easy to see which one is safer, and therefore which one stands better. And this is now basically unplayable for black. But yeah, he manages to hold on. Or one reason is because white didn't find the perfect moves. But yeah, let's see how it went. Here, white played or took on c5. Black recapture with the knight, which is the right thing to do, because first of all, you're threatening e4 and you're threatening to play d3. And if you're able to get this this bishop, even at the cost of one pawn, you will have some counterplay, you know, because it's not everything decided. And again, the only bad thing about black's position is his king safety. The development is okay and the counterplay is okay. So knight to d c5 was a right move, and here black white played f4, basically allowing black back in the game. A better move, and basically winning would have been to capture here on f6. And the idea is that you can always now play f4, and the line here towards the king is always opened. So, and this red here is decisive. Now it's as I said, the knight comes in, you can even take it here. You play this move, and not only do you get one pawn more, but again, the king here is completely horrible. If this pawn is taken, maybe you can play bishop to h6, you can attack f6. So this is a really bad position for black, and so basically lost. But yeah, I mean, white maybe in time trouble, he played f4. Now comes bishop to g4. White plays king to queen to e1, and the position now is roughly about equal, believe it or not. Black took here on d5. He wants to exchange pieces, and white captures on e5. With check at the same time, and here black played king to e8, which is the complete losing move. A better move, and believe it or not, this basically allows black to play on would have been to play king to g8. Why? Because after, if white here captures, which is the only logical move, this position here is about equal. I mean, it's not easy to play for black, but there are no immediate threats, and the king here is safe. I mean, I'm not saying that white is going to win here. He's clearly worse, but he can play on. Yeah. And in these kinds of positions, you want to get as much resistance as possible, because as long as you play on and the position is not hopeless, your opponent always has chances to make mistakes. So this would have been playable. But now after king to e8, basically your king is again stuck in the center, now opposite of the queen. And this is one of the reasons that I wanted to show you this game, because it highlights the value of king safety. You know, this one is losing this move, and king g8 basically holds. And it's all about king safety. This is just to show you how important it is. Here white just develops. He goes for bishop e3, and black goes for his old idea. He plays knight to d3, trying to block here this bishop. White plays king g3, normal attacking moves, you know. Getting the queen out, attacking g4 here, and black goes for bishop e2, and this looks kind of annoying, but white here calmly plays rook to e1, and that, yes, behind that, this is black's best piece, and if he exchanges this, the king is still stuck in the center. And look at these rooks. I mean, this one here is completely out of the game. So giving up the exchange here is basically the best move. And now he black wants to occupy d3 with his bishop. And white keeps his bishop alive. Going now, this bishop is eyeing on the king. He's basically threatening bishop to h5, and then it would be over. So we see g6, and we see bishop f3. And I mean, look at the activity. We have here this monster bishop pair. The rook is fabulous, to put it this way. And the rooks are still disconnected. The king is still in the center. This is hopeless. And now here, I can even afford to exchange. He plays e6, and black tries to get his last rook in the game, but this is almost over. The problem here for black after e6 is that white is threatening king to queen to c7, and then going for mate here, and this cannot be stopped. Again, he tried rook f8, but now comes queen c7. Here even, believe it or not, black tried queen to f5. Why is this not mate? Okay, maybe this is some kind of mistake. But basically, black resigned here. He has no moves. I mean, there's nothing he can do. And again, the big theme of this game was the king safety, the king being stuck in the center. You can sacrifice pieces if you manage to get some activity. You will always get some compensation. So this was a good runner game, and I would urge you to study the middle game. And I mean, the idea that black had here was that he didn't want to castle, so that he gains some tempi. But here it basically backfired. It's a gamble. If you like to gamble and you are the better player, or you think that you are the better player, you can go for these kind of variations. Otherwise, I wouldn't recommend them, because you will never be able to calculate them until the end. Nobody can. So it's up to you. But again, I think you should know these ideas. I think you should know the Marana variation. And yeah, thank you for watching. Bye bye.